Hello. Hi. What's up?
I don't know how to start a video.
Well, welcome to my first ever art vlog. I'm Kelly. I make penny pretzel comics. I've always wanted to start a YouTube, so very excited to do this. So I'm gonna show you guys kind of what I'm gonna do today. I'm gonna walk around, get some stuff for the pup, draw a little bit, and then I wanted to work on my process for how I taught myself how to draw a decent dog. I'm just gonna be upfront. I can't draw a lot of things. I can draw faces pretty well, but other things like hands, houses, chairs, bikes, horses, men, any animal, but especially dogs. So I promised my Instagram that I would show them how to draw dogs. If you want to follow me there, you can or not. So we're gonna do some of that today. But first, let's go do stuff. What's up, guys? So this is the best dog that I've ever drawn, and I just kind of wanted to walk you through basically how I came up with it. So this was my first attempt at that awesome dog. Obviously he doesn't look super awesome, this was very rough, but I knew this was generally how I wanted the pose to look. So I actually went onto Instagram and found something that was really close. This is super cute. This is an Australian Shepherd. This is actually the same dog that I'm getting soon. And I actually traced over him. I found that his proportions weren't exactly what I wanted, so I generally had the idea of what the shapes are after tracing it, so I was able to come up with that. And now I'm going to show you how to try to do it yourself. So I found another pretty good reference image. I recommend using anything that isn't directly straight onto the camera, so your dog has like a side profile or a three-quarters profile snoot. That makes it a lot easier. And this time I'm actually not going to trace. I'm just going to draw freehand looking at the image. Reason being, I don't think tracing really helped me all that much, but I think the process of getting the general shape of the dog down first is a good idea. Also, I tried to note as I was doing this rough sketch all of its like floofier parts or fluffy parts, and I tried to draw those in as I went, so I would have an idea of where I wanted those fluffy parts to be for the drawing. And now I'm just drawing in some details and things like that. The mouth was a little hard to figure out. Okay, just wanted to take a second, just as a break, to let you know what's going through my head right now. I think this looks horrible. At the same time, I also like it. Like, I didn't know that so much of being an artist would just be hating what you make. I mean, look at that. Is this good? No idea. I think it's garbage. It's a garbage dog. What came out of me, so garbage dog. All right, He actually is not bad. And I will continue to draw him, and he actually looks pretty funny. And it makes me smile. So those two thoughts live with inside me. If you have the same two thoughts about all your artwork, then you are just a normal artist. At this point in the drawing, he's really coming together. I'm just doing doing my lines over. I don't know what the technical term is, but yeah, I'm just tracing over my rough sketch with a darker color, and I'm really defining all of his floofy parts in this stage. That was my favorite part to actually draw, and yeah, I mean, I think it's pretty self-explanatory. I like to add in some curly, swirly bits. I don't know how to describe them, but the more like curled sections I like to throw in there, you know, whenever I'm feeling a little chippy. And yeah, I really, really like how this came out. I didn't really think I'd be able to do this again. Maybe that's why I couldn't do it the first time I tried to record this video, but he came out really great. So thank you. yeah, so here's the finished product. I think it came out awesome. So yeah, that's basically how I draw dogs.
Hey, so thanks for joining me today. I had a blast. I've never made something like this, so it means a lot to me if you've stuck around this long, especially if you don't like how I draw dogs. Which, if honestly you don't like how I draw dogs, why are you still here? but no, for real, thank you so much for watching. I love the idea of making videos. This is actually really hard for me because I don't have any experience being on camera, but I really wanted to do it because I wanted to meet and talk to more people about art, why it's awesome to do, how I do it, and things like that. So until the next video, vlog, or whatever, thanks for watching. Join me on Instagram. My handle is below, and I'll see you next time.